So far, we learned how to add contacts by either clicking on the New button or importing them from another file. There's another way you can add contacts to your contact folder, and that's by sending or receiving your contacts. For example, if I want to go ahead and send this off to somebody so they don't have to enter in my information into their contact book, of course assuming that they have Outlook 2007 or older, you can go ahead and right-click on your contact and go down and select Send as a Business Card. Click on that, it opens up the email, it attaches it as a business card, and displays your information down below. So all you have to do is go ahead and type in the email address, and then it's already there, so if I just hit the Tab key, it'll automatically fill in the rest and click Send. Well, if you haven't asked it already, I'll ask it, what am I sending? If I double-click and open up the attached contact, it'll send all the information here. My question is will it send any notes that I have or any details? It's sending some of the details, but look at this. Let me close out of here. Close out of here without saving it and open up my contact here. I've got some notes here. When I send it as a business card, it didn't add the notes. It added everything over here in the general view. When I went to the details view, it only added the department and my title here. It didn't add my manager's name, my assistant's name, so that's pretty good. You know, you can battle back and forth to find out what fields are going to be sent, but probably the easiest thing to do, let me close out of here, is just plain and simple create a new contact where you can add it and list only the information that you want in there that you can send off as a business card. That way I can have two contacts. I can have my contact information here that's all detailed and I want to keep track of my own personal information, and then I can have another contact, we'll call it Kurt Kershaw 2 down below, where I just have limited information that I don't care when I send that off what they see, because I'm not going to put everything in that contact. Double click to open it back up. Another way you can do this is you can come up on the contact tab and click on the send drop down arrow and also have the option to send it as a business card there as well. Close out without saving. You can also click on the send drop down arrow and select Internet Format V Card. When you select that, you really want to be extra careful on this one, because when you double click and open it up, it sends everything. It sends your notes. Go to the details, it sends all your details. I mean, there's no hiding it, okay? So again, just let me close out of here. Go ahead and send your business cards out, but just create a separate contact where you just put your name, maybe your title, your company, your website, and that's it. Keep it limited. Well, maybe your business phone number. Okay, so what if we're on the receiving end of somebody sending us their business contact information? Let's go to the mail folder, to the inbox. Let me click on send and receive. And there it is, right here. Well, first let me double click and open up the message. And Bob Ross sent me his business contact card. This is what it looks like. Now if I want to go ahead and add this to my contacts, just right click on his business card, go down and click on add to contacts. It opens up with his information. I can check out the details to see if there's any additional information he added for me, go back to general, and then when I'm finished, of course, be sure to save and close it. Now, remember, I had two different contact folders. I had my regular contacts, which were my business, and then I had my personal. Well, when it comes to receiving contacts, the default will always be the main contact folder. You cannot pick or define when I right-click what contact folder I want to add it to. For example, when I close out of here, let me go to my contacts folder. It's not in the personal, but when I go to my contacts here, there's Bob Ross. Of course, once I add him to my main contacts, then I can go ahead and click and drag him over to my personal side there. Something else. When you're in your main contacts or your default contacts folder and you double click and open it up, look in the lower left hand corner. There's nothing there, right? Well, when you go to another contact folder that you created, go inside there and you open up a contact, double click. In the lower left hand corner, it tells you what folder this contact is coming from. So if it's blank, just know that it's from your main folder, your contacts default folder. But if it has something here, then it's telling you this contact came from the personal contact folder. Thanks for watching. Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel, get notified of the latest videos, and for only $2 a month, you can have access to all my Microsoft Office training videos.